Hi friends, this is Manish Pandey. Welcome to UiPath RPA. Today we are going to learn about UiPath Dictionary. So here in this tutorial, we are going to learn about what is dictionary, how to create the dictionary, and what is IDictionary. So we'll also learn about the what is IDictionary, how to add items to dictionary, how to clear the dictionary, how to get the value from the dictionary, how to check for an existing key in a dictionary, how to remove elements from the dictionary, and how to check for an existing value in dictionary, and how to loop through a dictionary in UiPath. And at the last, we'll see what are the points that needs to be remembered. Left side, you can see here, these are the activity of dictionary, that is add to dictionary, clear dictionary, get from dictionary, key exist in dictionary, remove from dictionary, and value exist in dictionary. So we'll see one by one. I'm going to cover most of the things here in this video. So let's start this. What is dictionary? Dictionary is same as English dictionary. English dictionary is a collection of words and their definitions. So you have seen that in English dictionary, you will get the word and we get the definition also in the different language. So same way in UiPath, dictionary is a collection of keys and values, where key is like word. If we'll compare with the dictionary, this English dictionary, with the dictionary in UiPath, you can understand dictionary is a collection of keys and values, where key is like word and value is like definition. Let's suppose in the English dictionary, our key is apple and the definition is it is a fruit. So the same way we have the key and value in dictionary in UiPath. So every dictionary has pairs of keys and values. You can see here like dictionary TKey and TValue. The dictionary TKey TValue is a class of System.Collections.Generic namespace. So the dictionary which we are using, it's a class of System.Collections.Generic namespace. It can store any data types in a form of keys and values. It provides a mapping from a set of keys to a set of values. You can see here right side, here the keys and here the values. Like we have the apple, so value will be it is a fruit. We have the elephant, so value will be it is an animal. Here is the keys, it means today's date, then here is the value. Here the keys 1, then here is the value. Now system collections.generic namespace can be imported in UiPath Studio. So if you have learned .NET, so in .NET, like in C#, we will have to import the namespace, this namespace, by using keyword, like using system.collections.generic. So here in UiPath, we have the feature, we can go to the import and we can type this and then we can select that. So that will be imported in our UiPath Studio. So I'm going to tell you about the detail about the system collection generic dictionary. What is the TKey and what is the TValue? So here you can see system.collections.generic. This is a namespace and the dictionary is a class as per .NET. System.collections.generic is a namespace and the dictionary is a class. TKey and TValue is a parameters which we pass with the dictionary class. Now we'll discuss about the parameters. This TKey and TValue. What is this TKey and TValue? And what is the full form of this? So TKey, it's a type of key. So the type of keys in the dictionary is called TKey. So same as TValue, it means the type of the values in the dictionary is called TValue. Now for example, dictionary will be a string and dictionary key will be string and value will be string. It can be a string or it can be anything also. Same as other you can, the key will be string and the value will be integer. We have another, we can take key as a string and value as a object also. We can take key as an integer and value as a string also. we can take key as a string and value as a boolean also. So we have the lots of data type we can use here in the dictionary. Same as this, here in the keys we have the string here, and right side we have a string, integer and date also. Now how to create dictionary? So we'll see here how to create dictionary. So for that, create a variable of dictionary with the variable type dictionary string object or IDictionary string object. So here I have written string and object. It means our key will be string data type, string type, and our value will be object type. So object type means we can put here, we can take any types of value here. So that's why I have taken here object, or you can take here if you have the data in string format, string, then you can take here string. So here if you are going to create the variable of dictionary, then either you can select dictionary or you can select IDictionary also. I will tell you about this IDictionary later. So we need to create like this. The name will be dictionary and the variable type will be like this, dictionary string object. We must initialize the dictionary. Dictionary equal to new dictionary of string comma object. Like if you want to take the key as a string, then you can put here new dictionary of string, or if you want to take as an integer, then you can write here new dictionary of integer comma object like this. We can assign like this. Let me show you in UiPath Studio. Here before I start working on this, first let me take one flowchart, and either we can take assign activity to assign the this expression, this dictionary, new dictionary of a string comma object to the variable. So either we can take assign activity and we can create a variable here and pass that expression here, or we can directly, first let me show you here, either we can press Ctrl T K and then we can write here dictionary or anything like my dictionary or dict anything. So here, and now here we need to pass new dictionary of, so here we need to take new dictionary of. So once we, you know, mouse hover on this, we are getting right side class System.Collections.Generic dictionary of TKey comma TValue. It means this is the part of System.Generic collection.generic. So we'll have to write here dictionary of. So here we need to take of. Then what type will be our keys? So if we need to pass string, then we'll write here string, comma, our value type. So we'll take here string. So our both T key and T value both will be string. You can keep here anything. Now we need to go to the variable, and here this dictionary will be, as I shown you here, this should be either dictionary or IDictionary. So for that we'll have to go to the variable type, and here we can go to the browse for type, and we can write here dictionary. So if we'll go here in dictionary, so dictionary class is a part of System.Collections.Generic. So we'll have to go here System.Collections.Generic, and we can select this. So once we'll select this, click on this, then we get option here to select the type of key. So our type of key is string and type of value will be string. Here you can see dictionary, type of key and type of value, and then press OK here. Now we have dictionary created here. We have assigned this expression to our dictionary variable. It means we have created the dictionary with empty elements or empty items. Now we need to put the items here, value in the dictionary. Let me show you here next. What is IDictionary? As we already discussed here, we can create the variable, as I already shown you here. We can create a variable type as a dictionary, or we can take as IDictionary. So now I'm going to show you what is IDictionary. So IDictionary is the base interface for generic collection of keys, value, pairs. We can create a variable, we can create a dictionary and access it through the IDictionary interface. So you can understand IDictionary is the interface. We can create like this, we can create the dictionary variable and variable type will be IDictionary. We must initialize the dictionary same as the dictionary class for the this interface also. So we have to just go to variable type and we can change from here. We can go to the browser types and we just have to use IDictionary System.Collections.Generic IDictionary type key. Same as that we can select this string and string. Now press OK. Now we have the variable type IDictionary. Now let me show you how to add items to dictionary. How can, if we, now we have the dictionary created here. Now how can we add the items to dictionary? So let me show you here. Install Microsoft.Activities.Extension from the manage package to use dictionary activities. So if you have not installed this package in your UiPath studio, then you will not be getting dictionary activities. Like, let me show you here. Let me search for the dictionary activity. So I'm not getting any dictionary activities here because I have not installed this package Microsoft.Activities.Extension. So let me first click here on the manage packages and then go to the all packages, and here in the search box we need to write Microsoft.Activities.Extensions. So we need to take this one to use the dictionary activities. Now click install and then save this. So once it will reload all this dependency, it will add this and then we'll able to use the dictionary activities. All these dictionary activities we can use here. So now you can see here we have the all these activities available here. Add to dictionary, clear dictionary, all these things. This is under Microsoft Activities Extension statement. Now drag and drop the add to dictionary activity to the UiPath Studio. Once you drop the activity, it will show one pop-up to select types of key and values. So it means if you want to add the items to the this dictionary, then first we'll have to take one activity that is add to dictionary. So we'll just drag and drop here. So once you drag and drop here, it will ask to select the type. It means what will be the type. So our type will be a string and the value will be also a string. So let me press OK. Now which type of items you want to add to the dictionary? So this is our just basic example. I'm just going to show you. Let's suppose I have a URL and that will be in double quotation. This is a string, that's why. And here our value will be www.google.com. So this is our value. And once you double click on this, we will get the option of the dictionary. So we'll have to use the existing dictionary that we have created. So here you can right side see dictionary as a IDictionary. So this dictionary is a interface we have used. We are using this. So either you can double click on this and you can, you know, take the dictionary, or you can go to the right side in properties and you can write the created dictionary variable here. Now once we click on run, this value or this key value will be added to the dictionary variable. It means to the dictionary. Now if you want to check that this value has been added to the dictionary or not, we can just take one message box and we just need to, you know, use the dictionary, and then in the double quotation we just have to use the key name. So it's easy to fetch the value based on the key. So if you have the key, we can just check this, get the data, get the value. Let me run this. So once we'll run this, we will get this URL. Let me run this. So you have seen here we have got the www.google.com. So this is our value. So now we have added the keys and values to the dictionary. You can see here like this. So we need to take care of one more thing, that if we have created a dictionary of type of key string and the type of value is a string, then you can just pass only the data in string key and string value. You cannot add any other data types of data into this dictionary. If you want to add any other types of data, other types of value, then you have to create another dictionary and you can put that another name, and then you can add those value in that. So here we can just add string keys and string data type, string type, same as SQL database. If you have, you know, specified like this, for this name the data type will be varchar integer like number, then we can just add the data of those, that data type, same as here. So this dictionary we can understand like a data table or data table. Now if we need to create another, we need to add more data to the dictionary, then we can take another add to dictionary activity and we can drag and drop here and select this. The type key will be always this because we have assigned the new dictionary of string. Now press OK, then let's connect this again. Now I'm going to take this a key will be, let's suppose application name is SAP. So we need to pass the existing dictionary name so that it will add these key values to the dictionary. Now this is added. Now let me run this, and first time we have added the URL. Now I'm just going to check the this application is added to or not. Let me run this. So now we have added this key values to the dictionary. So we have got the value of the key, that is SAP. This is same as a dictionary. We can write here like this, this is for apple. So apple, this is a, it's a fruit, same as that. Now let me show you here how to clear the dictionary. The second one, second activity we are going to use for this, how to clear the dictionary, this activity will be used. So drag and drop the clear dictionary activity to UiPath Studio. Once you drop the activity, it will show one pop-up to select types of key and value. So here also it will ask to select the type of key and type of values like this, and then choose the type of key and value as per requirement and press OK. Enter the name of dictionary to clear all the items from the dictionary like this, and then we can clear the dictionary. So let's see the example how to clear the dictionary. Let's suppose we have created this this dictionary and we have added this key value to that dictionary. Now the we have to clear the dictionary. It means we have to delete all these records from the dictionary. Then we just, let me take one thing, that clear dictionary. So what we'll do, it will ask for the value, the type of key and type of value. So let me take this. So it means it is asking that which type of key and which type of value is exist in your dictionary. So press OK. Now it is asking what is the dictionary. So our dictionary name is dictionary, this one. So what will happen, once we'll run this, our dictionary will be cleared. It means all the records will be removed from the this dictionary. Now let me take one message box so that I can show you, is there a data available in this dictionary or not. I'm just taking this dictionary and I'm just taking this application, so it will check. If it is there, if dictionary is not clear, then it will show here this SAP. If it is clear, then we'll get the error. So here you can see we are getting this, the given key was not present in dictionary. It means this key has been removed. It means all these records has been deleted from the dictionary, right? So there is no use of this. The dictionary has been cleared. So if you don't want to use at the end of the project, then at last you can use the clear dictionary to clear all the records from the dictionary. Now the next one is how to get the value from the dictionary. So this is the activity we are going to use to get the data from, get the value from the dictionary. We'll drag and drop the get from dictionary activity to UiPath Studio to get the value of the given key from dictionary. Once you drag and drop the activity, it will show one pop-up to select type of keys and values, same as the previous. And then we have to choose the type of key and type of value like string and string and press OK like this. And then enter the name of the dictionary and key and variable in value. So here you need to pass the dictionary name and the key for which we need to get the value. And then the value will be a one variable. Let me show you one practical example. Here now let me remove this, and I'm going to take that activity. This one is get from dictionary to get the value from the dictionary. So I'm going to connect this here, and the type will be string. The value will be a show string. Press OK. And then here we need to pass the dictionary. The key will be, let's suppose I need to get the value of key URL. So I'm going to pass here in double quotation URL. And then here in the value, I need to get the value of this key URL. So I'm just going to create a variable, and that is called dict value. And with the use of this variable, I need to just use this created variable to get the value. Let me take one message box. I think we have the message box here in the background. Let me delete this and now select this. And here I need to just pass that dict value. So here in this variable, we will get the value of this key URL. And let me run this. So here you have seen we are getting google.com. It means here the value of this URL is google.com. So with the use of this get from dictionary activity, we can get the value of a specific key. So anytime if you require to get the value of any key, then we can just pass the key there, and we can create a variable, and we can use that variable anywhere to get the value of the key. Now the next is how to check an existing key in dictionary. If we have already created a dictionary and we have added the key and value to dictionary, then how can we check that this is already exist in dictionary or not? So for that, we have to use this activity to check whether a specified key exists in dictionary or not. So we'll drag and drop the key exists in dictionary activity. So this is the activity we need to use to check for an existing key in UiPath Studio. Once you drop the activity, it will show one pop-up to select the type of key and type of value, same as previous activities like this. And we need to enter the name and the variable, and then Let's see the practical example here. Let's suppose we have already created here, but you don't know that we have, you know, already added this key URL in the dictionary or not. So for that, I'm just going to take this activity to check the existing key in dictionary. So we'll take this key existing dictionary, and we'll select the key type, and this will be string, and press OK. So our key will be, I'm going to just check that the URL is already available in dictionary or not, and I'm just going to take the result. So this will show as a true or false. So I'm putting here control K, and then key exist, the value will be this, and this will be boolean. Let me select the dictionary variable, and here I am just using this key exist boolean variable, so it will show true or false. If the key is already available in dictionary, then it will show true, and not, then it will show here false. So let me run this. So we know here we have the URL key already available in the dictionary, so we'll get here true. We are getting true here. Let me change the key of this. I'm just putting here URL login, and then let's run this. So here you can see we will get false because this key is not available in dictionary. So we can use here the condition, like if the key exists equal to false, it means this is not available in the dictionary, then we can, you know, take one add to dictionary, and then we can add that key values to the dictionary, right? Now the next is how to remove elements from dictionary. Use this activity to remove an item with the specified key from a dictionary. Drag and drop the remove from dictionary activity to UiPath Studio. So this is the activity used in dictionary to remove the elements from the dictionary. So this is same as that. We have to just drag and drop this, and it will ask for the select type of key and type of value. So every time it will ask for this. So let me show you for remove from dictionary. So here I'm going to take this. Let me, you know, use the same thing. If this URL exists, so we'll take one if condition, or we can take a flow decision. Flow decision, and then if key exist equal to true. If it is true, then what we need to do, we need to remove the elements like this key from the dictionary. So I'm going to take this here in the left side, and we'll take one sequence, or we can take directly remove from. If it is true, then we need to take the remove from dictionary. We'll drag and drop here, and the type of key will be string, and type of value will be a string. Press OK here, and then we have already drag and drop here, connected here. Now the key will be, we need to remove this key, that URL, and the result will be like deleted something. I'm just taking this variable as a result, and then here in the right side we will take the variable, like in which, from which variable, from which dictionary we need to remove this key. If it will not pass here, so it will throw an error. So here it will have to specify from which dictionary. If you have multiple dictionary, then we'll have to specify also, and false will not take anything. So let me run this. So it will check first if it is. It means it has been deleted now. We can check from the output. Started. And let me take one message box here so that I can show you here. Then this is deleted or not. Connect here. So I'm just going to pass here that this deleted variable, and this is boolean variable. So what will happen, this will show if it is deleted, then it will show a message like true. If it is not deleted, then it will show as false. So we are getting here true. It means this has been deleted. So once if will, now I'm going to take one message box again and I will connect here. And then I'm going to use this key variable to check that this is available here or not. And let me run this. So here we have taken this remove from dictionary activity to remove that. So it has been removed. We are getting true. It means it has been removed. And now we are taking message box to see the see the value of that URL key. So it will show error. So you can see here we are getting error like the given key was not present in the dictionary because this has been deleted using this activity, this remove from dictionary. So that's why here we are not getting the value of this URL key. Now how to check for an existing value in dictionary? So we need to use this activity to check whether a specified value exists in dictionary or not. So drag and drop the value, drag and drop the activity. This value exists in dictionary activity to UiPath Studio, and then we need to again do the same thing. So value exists in dictionary, we need to check this. So let me delete all these things and take value exist. So again we need to take the same thing, the string, and the type will be a string. And here we need to take the value, let me check here, the dictionary will be dictionary and the value here. It means we need to check the value exists in dictionary or not. So let's suppose the value will be google.com. So we need to check that we have added this value in the dictionary or not. So let's suppose we have the sap value here. We have already one value sap in the application key. So I'm just taking this. I'm going to find this available in the sap value here or not. So in the result here, I'm just going to take one variable, and this will be boolean type. Control K, and the value exists, and then I am going to take one message box, so it will show true or false. So if this is available here in the dictionary, then it will show true. If it is not, then it will show false. So let me take this variable value exists and let me run this. So we know that this value is already available in the dictionary, so we'll get the true. Now we'll change the, so here we are getting true. Now I'm going to change the value sap1, and then let's run this and let's see this is available in a dictionary or not. So we are getting false. It means this is not available in the dictionary, so this value is not available. So with we have the lots of activities, we can use that to manage our dictionary. Now we'll see how to loop through a dictionary in UiPath. We'll see if you want to loop through dictionary to access each key value pair the used for each activity. If you want to loop through dictionary to access each key value pair, then use the for each activity, create a dictionary and add items to it. Take a for each activity, which will iterate over each item key and value in the dictionary and display the key value pair using message box activity. So let me use this. I'm going to take this, remove this, and I'm going to take one for each, because we have already created the dictionary, we have already added the items to the dictionary. So just we need to use the for each activity. So we'll take this one, not this, because this is for data table and this is for dictionary and collection or list. Connect this, and here we just need to pass the dictionary, and here in the message box we just have to take message box, and here we can just use item. So what will happen, it will loop through each key and value in the dictionary. It will show here in the pair. So we'll get here the option like URL, and the value is google.com. Second application, that is our key, and the value is SAP. So by this way we can loop through dictionary and we can get the data. Now the last one is, that is points to remember. So these are the points I'm going to show you that we need to remember while creating and working on dictionary. So first is, install the Microsoft.Activities.Extension from manage package to use the dictionary activities. I have already shown you that if you don't have this package installed in UiPath Studio, then we cannot use all this activity. So first we need to install this. Second, dictionary is case sensitive, so before adding the key to dictionary, convert them to either lower or uppercase. So I'm going to show you this one also. So let's suppose we have, I'm going to delete this, and here we have created a application. This is like a is in uppercase. So I'm going to take one message box, and here I'm going to take this dictionary, and in the open close bracket I'm going to just take like this application. I'm not putting here a in caps, in uppercase, and run this. So here you can see we'll get the error, because as it is showing the given key was not present in the dictionary. Why? Because the dictionary is case sensitive, so before adding the key to the dictionary, convert them to either lower or uppercase, otherwise you have to write the same as the key which is we have already added to the dictionary. Dictionary cannot include duplicate or null values, null keys, whereas value can be duplicated or set as null. So in the dictionary we cannot include the duplicate or null keys. Let me show you. If you are going to add to the dictionary same keys, like the application is already created, so we will not able to add, we will get the error. Let me take one add to dictionary. I'm going to take another activity, this is for same thing, and this will be string, and take another. Let me remove this. And let me connect this here. And then connect this with the message box. So this example is for only checking the dictionary cannot include duplicate or null keys, whereas value can be duplicated or set as null. So here I'm just going to take one key that is duplicate, that is application, or I'm going to take as a URL. So we have already added this key URL in the dictionary, and now I'm going to add this URL that duplicate again in the dictionary, and here I'm going to take, I know, only YouTube something, and in the same dictionary I'm going to add . Now let's run this. So here we'll see, we'll get the error because dictionary cannot include duplicate. We are getting error here, and item with the same key has already been added. It means this key has already been added. Now if we are going to change this, that is URL1, and we are passing here google.com, that is same as the previous this one. I'm going to copy this and paste this. So as I told you here in the points to remember, that whereas value can be duplicated or set as null. So we can pass here null value also, or we can pass the same thing as that. So let me run this. So here showing the given key was not present in the dictionary. Let me, you know, select this, and this was the error because we need to just change, and let me write here URL1 and run this. So this has been added. Now we are getting google.com because we have added this key and value to the dictionary. Now a dictionary stores key values pair where the key must be unique. That I already told you, that dictionary cannot include duplicate keys. So this is same, this must be unique. And the last, before adding a key value pair into dictionary, check that the key does not exist using key exists in dictionary activity. So as I already told you previous, that before adding the keys to the dictionary, use the key exists in dictionary activity to check the key exists in dictionary or not, and then add that. So if it is already exists, then it will not be added. Otherwise, if you'll directly add that, and if that key is already available in the dictionary, then you will get the runtime exception. So in the next video, we'll see how to add the config file data to dictionary, and we'll access how to access this data in the project. In the second video, we'll see what are the exceptions in dictionary, well, like which type of exceptions we get in the dictionary and how to resolve that. And in third video, we'll see dictionary properties and methods, and what are the important things about the dictionary. So we'll cover all these things in these three video also. So thank you so much, friends. Thank you for watching this video. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe this. Please press the like button. And if you have any question, please comment on my video, or you can send me on mail uipathr@gmail.com. Thank you so much, friends. Thank you for watching this video.